1 between Dallas and Seattle comes your way from American Airlines Center tonight. And it's time for our Choctaw Casino and Resort Durant marquee matchup. Sebi, what do you have for us?
We're going to look at two guys that are going to make a difference, or at least try to in tonight's tilt. Jared McCann, very good for his team on the road. But Jason Robertson at home, he's been the guy. When you look at it this season, he got 3 assists against the Pittsburgh Penguins. That was a record for him this season as well. But where he's so good is getting the puck and moving it toward the cage. And we look at the last 2 seasons at home, he leads the Stars in assists with 34 and points with 53. On the other end, this guy right here can really shoot the puck. 25-year-old, he's got 14 goals this season. Career high for him. 6 of those goals are on the road. 9 points leading the squad. Really watch, he's going to shoot from everywhere on the ice.
All season, the Stars have been lights out on home ice. They come into action tonight riding a 12-1 stretch at AAC. They look to add a brand new skin on the wall at home. Opening faceoff between the Stars and Kraken right after this.
Dallas Stars Hockey on Bally Sports is brought to you by Choctaw Casino and Resort Durant. Expansion now open, stakes raised. By Baylor Scott & White Health, changing healthcare for the better. And try Jack in the Box's new perfectly spicy $5.99 spicy cluck sandwich combo.
Dinner, pit stop back home before the Stars hit the road over the weekend. We bring you inside, check out the starting goalies.
3 straight wins for the youngster, the 23-year-old, Chicago, Minnesota, and Pittsburgh. He is playing in just his 41st career game. On the other end of it, Philip Grubauer, last year's finalist in the Vezina for the top 3 goaltenders in the National Hockey League. Looking for a little stronger performance from him this season. He's 1 of 3 goaltenders born and developed in Germany and played 100 NHL games.
Stars and the Kraken meet 3 times this season. The other 2 come back in April, final month of the regular campaign. This is the first ever meeting between the 2 teams. Puck is dropped. We are underway from American Airlines Center. Dallas dumps it in. It's Jamie Benn going to work. He's out there on a line with Tyler Seguin and Jacob Peterson, taking the spot that's been occupied the last couple of games by Denis Gurianov, 1 of 3 Stars to land in COVID protocol over the last 2 days. Stars will keep it in at the point, angle it in deep. Jamie Oleksiak wearing number 24 in the Kraken white. He was selected by the Kraken as an expiring contract, UFA to B. They wanted him that badly, picked him. He signed the 5-year new deal with them as it's iced for the first whistle of the game.
Yeah, Jamie Oleksiak, he's a guy, I'd love to see the progression from him from the first time that he was here with the Dallas Stars. Went to Pittsburgh, I really thought he developed his game. I thought there was maybe too much pressure on him early in his career to be that physical, hard-grinding defenseman. He's really developed into quite a player, and he's going about to set some career highs, I believe, this season in a lot of areas of his game.
They wanted him. They got him. 5 years, $23 million. Quick shot off the draw, fought off by Grubauer, had an awful lot of traffic. Despite all the changes we told you about, the Stars keep their first line intact. Here's Robertson. He scores! Again,
we're going to be taking this right off the top draw, up from the draw, Josh, and watch what happens right here. Nice little win. Everybody sectioned off, a set play, puck funnel towards net. This is where Seattle has some difficulty, is sorting out guys, and as the Stars move it around nicely, nice little opening, and that's what Jason Robertson does so effectively. Look at him just snap this home off a few bodies, and it still counts, Josh. Real nice job by Robertson and the crew.
Hintz was battling with Mark Giordano right in front, and it clanked off the skates of the Seattle captain. And what that trio does on home ice in the opening shift of games is unreal. They come out of the 2-hole in this evening, and it's exactly what Dallas wanted, especially we talked about the response, Sevi, coming off of Sunday, what they would do, what a shot in the arm that could be.
Yeah, definitely a determined effort right from the first shift on. They want to develop the forecheck, they want to lay some bodies, and they did a great job to start this game.
So Ottinger will keep it moving. They spot the young man an early 1-0 lead. Foxa will chip it in. It takes Jason Robertson all of 50 seconds of this hockey game to extend his overall point streak to 8 games and his point streak on home ice up to 11. Clogged up along the boards deep in Seattle territory. And Glendening keeps it moving. Fox up. He gets boxed out by Wenberg. Pops loose to Donato and then rolls out to neutral ice. A foot race for it there. Appleton trying to get around Sakura, who just did recover in time. Long stretch pass, Glendening can't connect. Results in an icing against the Stars.
We're going to go back and have a look at that goal, Josh, because I think it's with all the pinballing of the puck going around. Now let's watch closely. We're going to key on in front of the net. The shot comes. We're going to see if it goes off rope base. Yep, it went off his skate off the right side. And then off Giordano, the defenseman. But it's really because of the hard work, the forecheck, and the quick shot right there. Yep, off the toe and in. I scored many like that, Josh.
Scored many. I'm just wondering if you know offhand exactly how many.
No. Okay. Yes, actually.
We gotta get the guys in the truck to work on those numbers, get a highlight reel going here. It's Ottinger who secures the tight angle bin and hangs on to it. Game just over 2 minutes old. Hints from Robertson and Pavelski.
And for Seattle, they do this quite often. They've given up 38 goals in the first period. And that's way too many. When you're a team that's struggling defensively to cough up goals in the first period and then have to work, you challenge more, you make mistakes, you're pressing a little bit too much, and that's why you lose hockey games, and that's why you're seeing the record the way it is for this Kraken team. I love to say Kraken.
Yeah, it's great. It was the polarizing game early on. There's a shot by Donskoy, goes through and wide. There's so much anticipation once Seattle announced they were going to get the team, what the name would be, what the logo would be, all the buildup in a terrific sports town. Jerseys are pretty outstanding in person too, aren't they?
Yeah, fancy. And I know you like fancy.
Lindell with a chip up the wall. Rhett Gardner just summoned with all the absences for the Stars. Wearing number 49, he's making his NHL season debut. Played 28 games last year. Ben will fire it in. Yanni Gord, formerly of the Tampa Bay Lightning. An angled pass, kept in. Haskinen with a shot, hit traffic. Suter left side in front, and Peterson. Boy, did he try on the one-timer down to a knee and just fanned. Blackwell, big bounce off the backboards. He'll catch up himself. Scored a goal on Monday night in a tough 4-3 loss by the Kraken to Colorado, beginning of a three-game road trip. Yanni Gord funnels it low. Down in the near side corner, Larson. Now Blackwell with it, taken from the Rangers in the expansion draft. Gord with a shot, blocking it well was Kiviranta. Gord banks it low, Blackwell now following up, turnaround shot. That one goes wide off the stick of Cali Yarncroke. Stars will steal, tail end of a shift for both sides. Ben skates it into Kraken territory. He gets ridden off, but still nearby as he collided with Adam Larson. Pops loose to Jared McCann. 14 goals, he leads Seattle this season in that department.
A lot of zone time for Seattle in that first little foray towards the net, but they really didn't create anything off of that. Stars did a real good job of protecting the middle of the ice.
Carson Soucy bumps it around. Now a bouncing puck, the Stars catch up. Pavelski couldn't get much on a backhand pass. Good reach by Klingberg to knife it away at the center line. Dallas back in, the Dallas shot, save Grubauer. Rebound Klingberg, tried to feed it back across. Clank but stayed in the zone. Robertson, up high for Lindell. Now Klingberg, from the point, shot, bounced off Grubauer, rebound, fought for it, is loose. Wax at it from Robertson and Hintz, and they could not find Pater. Cleared out to center. Klingberg ahead for Robertson. Surveys the scene, understands his line mates need a change, so he'll just bump it back for Klingberg. All three forwards can shift.
If you're a defenseman for any opposing team, that top line is absolutely scary. I believe that last attempt went off the post there, so another great opportunity for that top line.
Giordano, and it comes out Mason Appleton, formerly of the Winnipeg Jets. and lifted into the Seattle bench out of play.
Well, Josh, let's go back and have a look at that opportunity. Real nice job again. You can see how well the Stars are moving the puck around. And then it's just fired towards the cage, and oh my goodness. Watch from up top here. Puck bounces off the pipe, and oh, nice battle in front though by the Kraken and their defenders to make sure the Stars don't get that. You want to tie up sticks. When it hits a goalie or hits the post, tie up some sticks to make sure the opponent doesn't get that.
Early shot advantage, 4-2 Dallas. They've got the early goal 50 seconds in. We've already seen a couple of instances in the game where there have been rebounds, second chances off of Grubauer. Here's Foxa with a shot. He rifled it up high. Collected by Wennberg. Around, and it's Jamie Oleksiak. Now Wennberg. Delays as he slices through center. Tosses it in. Ottinger cuts it off behind the net and one-hands it for Yanni Hakanpää.
Stars are having absolutely no problems coming through the neutral zone. As they move the puck up, they're finding the right play, good support, and that allows them to maneuver up ice, and just like that play right there, now they can enter the zone.
Ben will do it with a pass to Peterson, but a little over-anxious Tyler Seguin offside. Just over 6 minutes gone by, and the Stars' top line, they hit the ground running once again. Roope hits with the game's first goal 50 seconds in. And back on the board early, 1-0 they have the lead on the goal by Roope hits, but the fingerprints of Jason Robertson all over at 7.
Yeah, look at this, and earlier, you know, he was throwing pucks away, as you would imagine a young player, not taking the time, not having the patience, and that's really what happened. Everybody who steps on the ice into the National Hockey League, it is so much faster than the American League, college. So now that he's gaining more confidence, he's holding on to pucks more, just like he did on that last goal, and a real nice job by him. Continues to be strong at home.
Suter with it between the blue lines to Haskinen, and Dallas back in. Far side, Jamie Benn. Boy, was he terrific Sunday afternoon in St. Louis. Couple of chances, couldn't result in anything on the board, but an outstanding engaged performance by the captain as it's iced by Dallas.
And there you have Rick Bonus. Probably calmed down a little bit, hasn't he, Josh? You know, a little cup of coffee and a run, and you're feeling pretty good about yourself. But yeah, very fired up after the last game, last tilt. He knew coming into this one, he wanted to make sure that the boys were ready. He understands that Seattle is not one of the top-tier teams in the National Hockey League. But this is a team that works, this is a team that can grind, and with any team, if you give a little bit too much rope, you know what happens.
Unfortunately, a little lighter in the wallet. He was fined $25,000 by the NHL for the outburst at the tail end of the game, and anyone who was watching it, from the Stars' perspective, the way they played and how that game flipped, certainly understand the frustration from the head coach.
I got a jar here. I got a one Canadian dollar in already, so we're making our way up.
Yeah, the tip jar, the GoFundMe. Fought for in the circle. It's Suter with it. Over to Foxa. He's been in the game a long time. He said that was the first big fine he's ever received from the NHL.
He's doing good.
I want to hear about some of those smaller fines, though, as the puck up and out of play. Fans, you can join Jeff K and the Dallas Stars Ice Girls at Texas Live in Arlington this Friday night for an official watch party. Cheer on the Stars as they take on the Florida Panthers and enter to win cool prizes and giveaways. You can find the full watch party schedule right now at DallasStars.com. Restart draw comes just outside of the Dallas blue line. 1-0 Stars in front. Esselindell, switch of directions. Nice job to shed the pressure of Blackwell. And Robertson will softly play in. Vince Dunn, he goes down awkwardly in the corner. It was Roope Hintz. Cali Yonkro comes in and they have words and then some.
Stars again getting some interior pressure with some hard work. And you know, Roope, he's going to get up on the forecheck. Going to have a look at it as the puck has maneuvered in. Again, Stars having no problems getting up ice. Yeah, a little bump on the back right there. You got to be careful in that area. And the Kraken take a little poke at Hintz for that. As Dunn, the former St. Louis Blue, gets nailed for cross-check.
Cross-checking the call against Rope Hintz. That's the first penalty of the game and a Stars penalty kill that gave up two, certainly controversially, in their last time out in St. Louis. Wound up going 3-for-5. They were so good prior to that final 2 minutes against one of the top power play units in the NHL. Kraken, they are 18th in the league, 19.1%. Here's McCann, he's the guy you gotta watch on it. Gets the shot away, it's blocked, and Dallas clears.
That's a good puck movement this morning when they were working on it. You could tell they were pressuring with their penalty killers, trying to force it, and getting ready for tonight's tilt.
Taken away by the Stars. Fox, it didn't like the look, so instead just tries to burn seconds on the clock, delays before shooting it down. McCann leads Seattle with 5 power play goals. Last year, 7 of his 14 goals were also on the power play. He and Eberle, number 7 with the puck right now, lead the charge for the Kraken man advantage unit. It's McCann with it near side. He'll rim it around, makes its way to Eberle, formerly of the Oilers and Islanders. McCann, nice job to take the bank off the skate, and then triangle to Yarncroak, who scored. What a setup. What a finish by Seattle. Power play goal, and they've got the equalizer.
McCann is usually the guy that's scoring the goals. He's got 5 on the air, but watch as this puck wheels around. This is exactly what they were working on this morning. Oh, a little collection off that right foot. Yeah, a lot of teams use this where it's the quick little play to the side of the net, and just right there, you see Yarncroak already ready to get down on that one knee. You can see how close he was. That is what we call prime scoring opportunity, and they don't miss from that area.
And unfortunately for the Stars, it's the latest in a string of power play goals against. They've now surrendered power play goals in 7 of their last 8 games. And that was a nifty setup all the way around from Seattle. Cali Yarncroak, the Stars know all about him. He was a career Nashville Predator before going to Seattle in the expansion draft. It's his 5th goal and 11th point of the season. So 1-1 hockey game. Not even half the period in. Rope Hintz, who is in the box for the cross-checking call at the time of the goal. Back out there as part of the top line, trying to get it back. Stars steal, and they do. Haskinen, pressured by Jonas Donskoy. Now it's Sheahan. Around for Morgan. Not cleared. The reverse. Carson Soucy will use the glass 200 feet later. That'll be icing against Seattle.
Dave Hextall is a guy that they brought in. Communicates really well with players. Been around the league, or a guy that's gone from the college game to the professional game, did a short stint in Philadelphia, has to learn the game here, but rave reviews on him and how he communicates with players, and kind of the right kind of coach. We had Roger Nielsen when I started with the Florida Panthers, the expansion team, and he was quite the teacher as well.
Klingberg from the corner sends it out. Here's Lindell, a shot fought off. Getting a piece with the glove was Grubauer, and then it banked up high. Ben going back to work in the corner. Trying to reload for Klingberg, and it slipped away. You're talking about that. What is it about this job with an expansion team that a coach really has to have that maybe other NHL coaches aren't tasked with the same responsibility?
Well, the group not been together, and you're building those systems and working together, knowing exactly what the coaches want, the responsibility, and that's where the Kraken have had somewhat of trouble in their own zone. You can see they're running around, and when you don't support your teammates, it's an issue.
It's done, hustling to get back. Moves it around, getting knocked down at center ice is Appleton. Tanner Caro nearby, wearing number 64. He's also wearing the full protection with the face shield. What a tremendous sight it is to see Caro back on the ice 25 days after he took that scary hit on December 18th. The hit from Brett Connolly in the Chicago game had to be stretchered off. The tremendous sight for everybody in this building to see him back out there in a Star sweater.
They started with the wire cage in practice and then moved to the bubble. I think bogs up a little bit. I don't know. I'm a proponent of the wire cage, but obviously he preferred to put the bubble on.
Giordano, little short pass with McCann. All the way down it goes. This will be another icing against Seattle.
Essa Lindell has the ability, a nice little twisted wrister he has. This is what happens. See how much room he has out there. You don't want the defensemen in the defensive zone coverage to have that much room. And then as the puck comes up, there he is. He's in perfect position. Nice job DeForest there. You got to really read. There's a player coming off behind you. You got to be careful as a defenseman not to give up that interior position.
Up high, it's Suter at the line. Drags with it. Plays a game of catch with Haskinen. Haskinen, one-timer, low wide, rebound, score! Joe Pavelski in the perfect spot. Took the bank off the backboards. Buries it home, and the Stars have the lead once again.
Nice little play here, moving it across, and Haskinen, I think he shanked that one a little bit from high in the top portion of the ice, but it's the quick puck movement you can see. But there's three guys up top for the Seattle Kraken, that is too many. It's an outnumbered opportunity. And how about that for positioning? Great veteran move. Like I say, you don't have to do too much. You gotta be in front of the net, proper position, and you're going to get some goals like that. And you can imagine Joe Pavelski again in prime position.
Roope Hintz and Joe Pavelski entered play tonight, tied for the Stars' lead with 13 goals apiece. For about 10 minutes and 10 seconds, Hintz had moved in front. Pavelski just catches him. They each have 14 now. They've got the two tonight in a 2-1 Dallas lead. So offense early and often here in the first ever meeting between these two clubs. Ben will chip off of a teammate on the Stars bench and out of play. Joe Pavelski, his entire career has been spent in the right place at the right time at the net front, right there. He gives Dallas the advantage once again. Another big night for the Stars top line. Dallas leads 2-1 as we check out tonight's forward leaderboard.
And we're gonna look at some trios out there in the National Hockey League, and you notice it's over the last two seasons. Oh, we got an update, went from 64 to 66 just. So that's a shocker for this squad. But how about those names out there? Just for those of us who watch this team every single night, it amazes us how easier and how fluid they are reading off each other. That's a well-balanced, that's called chemistry.
Yeah, you look at the other names, the other lines that they're in that company with. There's a line that was formed last year and just magic happened. You hoped if you were Rick Bonus that it would carry over into this season. You don't know such a small sample size in that year as this puck is up and out of play. This is going to be a delay of game against Seattle. So the Stars are going to get a power play out of that and a chance for that top line to do some damage now up a man.
We're going to have a look at it. Off the side, pressure. Larson, the defenseman, under pressure. Back in the day, that used to be the play, if you ask old defensemen, used it often. So obviously they brought in that rule just for that. You want to put it off the glass and out to get it under, away from that pressure. The Stars have been really all over the Kraken and force that particular penalty.
The Stars power play is brought to you by TXU Energy. The first of the night for the Stars. They win the draw, go to work. Just under 26%. They've got the number six power play unit in the NHL. Klingberg, shot! Blocked en route and then off Klingberg's stick and down the other end.
Yeah, going back to Seattle this morning, the penalty killers were really trying to pressure. They're jumping all over the place, so whenever you see the Stars mishandle the puck, they're going to be jumping like crazy.
Klingberg, he's the lone defenseman out there. Michael Roffel is out there for a moment as well. He'll head off, part of a change. Remember, the Stars are without Denis Gurianov and Alexander Radulov, both in COVID protocol, both players on the power play. Hintz gets tugged, and a penalty is coming up. This is a delayed call against Seattle, another one. Robertson's shot is stopped. Dallas is gonna have a two-man advantage for 1:08.
Gonna play right up the middle, and then it's all, how did he pick that up off the air? And then is a minor mauling as he goes toward the cage.
Yeah, probably 28, 2 minutes, okay.
So yeah, they have to really dig in on him. There was no other way because of the speed and that hand-eye coordination to knock that puck down, put it to the ice. It always amazes me by those players with that kind of speed and the hands to go with it. That's pretty impressive for young Rope Hintz.
And making matters worse for Seattle, it's a pair of defensemen who are in the box. Soucy and Adam Larson, who picked up the delay as their top penalty killer. Neither one of them available. Huge opportunity for the Stars.
Well, they come in pairs. They come in pairs, right?
Yes.
They're lonely.
Yes, they even go in pairs to the sin bin. 5-on-3, spread out Dallas in front. Robertson delays. He scores! What a move! Jason Robertson on the doorstep. Terrific hands. Doubles the Dallas lead.
Recently, we've seen Tyler Seguin do this type of play in front of the net. It's the puck movement, finding open areas. Nice little 5-on-3, yeah, and then he drags Grubauer one way. You're going to see the goaltender, Grubauer. He's pushing off one way. And you actually, you're making the move as a player before that puck even gets to you because you know the goalie has to cheat to his right to get that puck, and you're going the other way, and there it is again. Mr. Robertson.
That line now has goals by all three forwards in this period. And Dallas stays on the power play for a long time. It was only 17 seconds into the 5-on-3. So Soucy still in the box for 80 more seconds. Here's Sheahan shorthanded. Suter had lost his stick. He's out there using his frame instead. And then Ban runs right into Gord.
Power play goal.
So the Stars get goals 2 minutes and a second apart. Even strength, Pavelski, then the 5-on-3 power play goal from Robertson. Robertson's fourth power play goal of the season. Back to work in the 5-on-4 now, Dallas. Suter to Ben. A handoff. Seguin goes to Ben behind the net, drags it with them. Jacob Peterson sandwiched along the boards near side. Puck comes free. Yarncroke able to skate it out. He's there with Donskoy. His pass got through.
That's where the Stars have to be tough. This Seattle team, they battle. They're going to fight along the walls. You have to be ready to put on your work boots and go after it as much as you can because they're going to win those type of battles along boards.
Pass for Pavelski. Hopped on him. Dallas has to reset. Klingberg for Robertson. His pass. Across the line, Pavelski threads it to Lindell. 10 left on the power play. Shot blocked, not cleared by Sheahan. And Blackwell is able to clear it all the way down, and that will do it. Stars go 1-for-2 on the power play. Soucy out of the box. 5-on-5 hockey as Robertson splits in. Chipped by Dunn, then delivered right back in by Dallas. A wholesale change for the Stars. Jordan Eberle hops it cross corner. Hockenbaugh first on the scene. Sent down by Raffle and Dunn is pursued quickly by Glendening. To the near side, Sekera arm in arm with Eberle. And Raffle, good hustle to get underneath McCann. Moves along to the far side. Chipped and it's held in by Fox and a forward up at the point. Raffle switch of directions, trying to shed Dunn, centered it just out of the reach, Glendening. And Hockenbaugh fanned as he leaned into one, came right back to him. Sekera forced to play off the sidewall and rims it in deep. Fox in the corner, turns to the forehand, feeds for Hockenbaugh. His shot floated, save made. Grubauer, another rebound, lurked into the slot, but it was clear.
Two times there, the defense pinch up, first to a Sekera and then Hockenbaugh. Rick Bonus talked a lot about trust. He's trying to make sure that the guys trust each other. You have to be working together and trust your partner, your forwards, to do that.
Suter laid into the zone, took the pass towards the blue line. Good work by Rhett Gardner, and then he gets bumped off. Lifted out by Donato all the way down. To have enough for icing, it's waved off. Ace getting collected just in front of the end line. Caro, one-touch pass for Kiviranta. His fourth line is Kiviranta, Caro, Gardner, and then it's touched offside against the Stars. Hints at Pavelski had already tallied. So, Jason Robertson on the 5-on-3. A beauty to complete the trifecta, all three on the board.
And what that first line is doing. Robertson, Hintz, Pavelski again at home have been outstanding. Puck movement, smiles all around. They just dissected the Seattle Kraken here in this first period to go up 3-1. This is a thing of beauty, Josh, right now.
They are as hot as they get. They've planted the Stars to a 3-1 advantage. Shot saved by Ottinger. He hasn't seen a ton of work so far in this period, already down into the late stages of it. That is just the fifth shot that he's faced. Puck lifted over the glass from center ice, so that'll bring a whistle.
So again, going back to that first line, there they are, heading back on the ice. Look at these numbers right here. Pretty much just under 50%, Josh. You're the math guy here, but I think that's what it is. Yeah, it's the first time all three have scored in the same home game. That's a little surprising to me.
How about the same home period? It didn't even take them long. They are up to 7 points between the trio in a game not even 20 minutes old. Just seems automatic at this point, games at American Airlines Center. You're going to have a big night from the three of them. They're out there right now. Pavelski is taken away by Borgen. And back for Jamie Oleksiak.
It's not only that they score goals, but it's how they work in the neutral zone. And Joe Pavelski, to me, has a lot to do with that, how he sections off areas of the ice and forces turnovers.
Fought for in front of the vacant penalty boxes. It pops loose. Hakanpää feeds for Foxa. Dallas is in. Foxa will send it around. Oleksiak off for Johansson. He had a goal and an assist on Monday for Seattle. Johansson grabs, reverses. Waffle there quickly, collides with Borgen. They cancel out. Now Oleksiak. It's the first time Oleksiak is facing the Stars as a member of Seattle, obviously, but the fourth time in his career. Faced him three times when he was on that about 13-month stay with Pittsburgh you were referencing earlier. As it's iced by Dallas, and now a message from Choctaw Casino and Resorts. Oleksiak played 286 games with Dallas over 9 seasons, 2 stints. Got a nice ovation at the first media timeout. He really grew into that role. It was a winding route for the 14th overall pick about a decade ago. Lindell in the attack zone on the near side boards. He ties up with Everly. Caro gets shoved by Larson. Two of them exchange paint. It's jammed along the wall, and the officials are urging play to go on.
German call that a stau.
Right?
I think so. It's a little traffic jam in the middle of nowhere. Oh, I hope I got that right.
Yeah, I did too. I like it though. I'm gonna ask you a few more terms. Kiviranta shoots it in. Final minute of play, first period. Outlet feed got away from Donskoy. And taken by Sagan, who weaves back. Little handoff with Klingberg. Work to Lindell. He fires in from center. Kraken will collect. Chip and chase. Ryan Donato. Ottinger stays put. Lindell used the frame to get there in front of Donato. And now here come the Stars on the counter. It's Ben. Across the line. Feeds for Sagan. Hopped on him. Still got a shot away. Redirection by Ben sent it off target. Lifted to center where Suter gloves. Eero Heiskanen back for Suter. A dozen seconds left in the frame. Tail end of a shift. The Stars will get it in deep and change. Top line out there. Do they have some last second magic? Just keep away time for Soucy in Seattle. And the horn sounds ending a terrific first period by the Stars and a terrific first period from the usual suspects.
I don't know what it's different. Maybe it's me, Josh, but I think this team played pretty well in the first period, bringing them a little luck from up in the booth. But yeah, real nice job, and they really dictated play. They moved out of their own zone effectively. They went through the neutral zone with ease, and then they were able to create a lot on the offensive zone.
If you want, I'm willing to give you the credit. Top line gets a little as well, though. 3-1 Stars lead it, 20 minutes in the books. Stick around. First intermission report comes your way next.
The Kraken for the first time in Seattle's inaugural season. And after the first 20 minutes of play, all three members of the Robo Hintz Pavelski line have scored, and it's 3-1 Stars at American Airlines Center. Welcome in. I'm Lauren Callender alongside Brian Ray and Ben Bishop. Guys, it took 50 seconds for the Stars to get on the board in this one. No surprise, it came at the hands of the Stars top line. Ben, what makes those three so special?
Well, we talked about the response, so I think that was fast enough. And I think they just read off each other so well, and they all bring a different thing. Obviously, Rupe with the speed, Robo with the vision and the playmaking, and then obviously Pavelski getting to the net front and tips and finding different ways to score around the net. So when all three of them get together, it usually makes up for a good game, and obviously it's not disappointing tonight.
I love that all three goals for the Dallas Stars were right on the edge of the blue paint. Clearly they were getting position interior-wise. They were penetrating that defensive shell. That makes life difficult for Philip Grubauer, and it's why the Stars are up.
Well, Brian, four goals between these two teams in the first period of this one. Three of the Stars' goals, all again from that top line. Walk us through the highlights from the first frame.
The first period to enjoy, and as you said, Lauren, less than a minute in, the Stars holding the puck in, the shot from Jason Robertson. Bish, it actually bounces off a couple of skates. It's not just Rope Hintz who gets credit, but Mark Giordano as well.
Absolutely, and I think that's why you want to throw pucks to the front of the net early in a game, because you never know what kind of bounce you're going to get. And as a goalie, you just kind of, you brush that one off, because when it goes off of two different people's skates and then the net, there's not much you can do about it.
You see the overhead look as the Stars get the opening goal. Now they put it up on a power play opportunity for the Kraken. Great touch passing in front. Kalle Yarncroft with his fifth of the season. That looks like about as difficult to handle for Jake Ottinger as you'll see.
Yeah, as a PK, you don't really want to let these passes go through, but sometimes you have to, tip your cap when they make three, perfect passes in a row like that. And, you want to be able to try to read that, but obviously it happens that quick. It's hard to keep up.
Fifth of the season for Yarncroft, but the Stars would regain the advantage. The point shot off the end wall, and Joel Pavelski, Johnny on the spot.
Yeah, and as a goalie, again, you're sitting here saying, are you kidding me with these bounces? But obviously, he knows where to go. He finds the open ice there, and kind of a fortunate bounce off the boards, but we'll take it.
And you can see the reaction from Grubauer. He never saw it. So the Stars have the 2-1 lead. They would add the icing on the cake. A 5-on-3 power play, and Jason Robertson, filthy mitts in front on a play like that.
That's just exceptional patience. I don't think people realize, as a goalie, you're thinking this guy's going to deflect it into me or take it to his backhand. But look at him. He just takes it to his backhand, has a sip of coffee, keeps going with it, and then puts it in the back of the net. I mean, that's, very, very few guys in the league can do that.
So Rope Hintz has 14 on the year. Joe Pavelski has 14. Jason Robertson with his 13th. I mean, that is a three-headed dragon attacking the Kraken right now.
Ben, we talk a lot about those guys on our show, so yeah. Just be prepared, okay? When we return on Stars Live, we look at game stats, and again, we talk more about the Stars. Top line coming up after the break. Welcome back to the Jack in the Box intermission report. The Stars and Kraken meeting for the first time this season. It's 3-1 Stars after the first 20 minutes of play at American Airlines Center. And looking at the numbers from the first period, Seattle's lone goal coming on the power play. Dallas able to convert with the man advantage as well this evening. Dallas outshooting Seattle 10-5, and the Stars absolutely dominating in the faceoff circle, winning 71% of the draws. Ben, looking at these numbers, what stands out most to you?
Well, I think when you see the faceoff percentage and how well we've done in the faceoff, you're controlling the puck, and then when you outshoot them 2-1, and not only the three goals, but also a post in there and a chance for Petey in the slot on a one-timer. So we've had some great opportunities, and I think that starting with the puck, winning those faceoffs is key.
The Stars had a 60.7% Corsi. They possessed the puck for the majority of that period. Winning faceoffs at that rate sets up possession numbers like that.
All three goals coming from three guys we like to talk about a lot: Jason Robertson, Roope Hintz, and Joe Pavelski. This season at home, Brian, these three alone have combined for 67 points. Pretty good season at home, huh?
It's pretty impressive. And the thing that stands out to me is the balance. I mean, 23, 23, 21 in terms of the numbers. And, you know, Mish, you said they read off each other so well, but there's no one player that carries this line. It could be one of those three guys on any given night that seems to have the spark. Tonight, it feels like it's all three of them, but they were involved in just about every piece of that first period.
Exactly. They all lean on each other. They all do something great, and that obviously helps when each person does something exceptional. And not only, you know, are they doing so well at home, but I mean, how fast do they start every game? I mean, we don't even have to wait a minute before we have a goal.
All right, guys, we've got the second period coming up next at American Airlines Center. It is 3-1 Stars, Brian.
Well, frankly, if they keep it up, just when you look at the second period, and if they can continue doing what they do, we'll see what the longer line change does. But moving towards that second period, I don't know if you change anything if you're the Dallas Stars. Bish, it felt like from the moment the puck dropped, they were in full control, especially deep in the offensive zone below the faceoff.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think, you know, a team that's been on a losing streak, you want to just keep the pedal to the metal here, keep taking it to them.
All right, it's 3-1 Stars as we head to the middle frame. Second period coming up next. We'll see you right back here in the second intermission.
Resort to Rent. Expansion now open. Stakes raised. Do what cable can't with Frontier's 100% fiber optic network. And by your Texas Ford dealers. Ford is the best in Texas.
Fans, join us as we retire Sergei Zubov's number 56 on Friday, January 28th at 6 p.m. before the Stars host the Washington Capitals. First 8,000 fans in attendance receive a replica Zubov jersey retirement banner courtesy of Bud Light. Secure your seats at DallasStars.com. Welcome back. One period in the books. Josh Bogaron alongside Brett Severin. Zuby would have liked that first period. The Stars lead it 3-1. He's the subject of our Blue Cross Blue Shield Legends of the Game, Sevy.
Yeah, well, you saw the picture there. What you notice about Zuby is he continued to have his heads up when he made plays. Yeah, he was great at defending. Oh, look at that little sauce through the middle of the ice. Nice one up the middle. That's what when you played with Zuby, you found a hole. He was able to find it no matter what distance it was. What a player he was. Zubov, outstanding.
We can't wait for that. Just over 2 weeks away. Number 56 heading to the rafters. It's been a big month for retiring Dallas greats. We'll join the handful of Stars who are up there. And then across the way, number 41, newly minted, Dirk Nowitzki. Stars will come out through center. It's John Klingberg. Second period, Stars will look to pick up exactly where they left off. Kraken with other plans. It's Yanni Gourde, has help, and his shot gets blocked by Esa Lindell. Now out for Klingberg. Reaching up is Dunn, looking to stretch and restart Gourde. He's got Appleton. It's Gourde. His pass had to go aerial over Lindell, who went down to block it, and a little too off target for Mason Appleton.
Giveaways. That's the reason you got to be careful with your giveaways or transition in the neutral zone. Real nice play by the Kraken to get it up ice.
Stars outshot Seattle 10-5 in the opening frame. They scored 50 seconds into the period. Here's Roope Hintz starting in a backhand. And it was turned aside. Philip Grubauer there, an early tester. Hintz cuts it off and keeps it in. Robertson, his shot blocked off of Larson. The Kraken will stretch the other way. Ryan Donato drops it off. Wenberg, good play to get back Haskin and tie up the stick. Suter just did muscle it out as Wenberg was going for a pick puck.
Yeah, Miro, that skating not only offensively, right? His ability to come back. He never gives up on a play. We talk about the competitiveness of him, not just in the offensive end of the ice. He wants to come back and help.
Here's Michael Roffle. in for Dallas. Down the right side, takes a couple of bumps by Eberle. They tie up in the corner. Susie nearby along with Glendening. Fox at third forward there. Helped pry it out. It's Hockenpah drive, and he blasted it wide. Yanni Hockenpah. They're leaning into that one. He's looking for his first goal as a member of the Stars. He had two last year in 57 games split between Anaheim and Carolina. Lifted up off the glass, rolls all the way back wide of Ottinger. Icing is waved off. Hockenpah the stretch to Caro. He's got Foxa back for Caro. Just did bounce away from him in the dot. Cleared in a foot race for it. Ottinger will step out and away from the on-rushing Donskoy.
Kraken trying to move the puck up quickly by stretching the zone.
Kiviranta with a shot, gloved by Grubauer, and he hangs on.
Let's have a look here. Klingberg coming up the wall. Stars Bingo tries to muscle one in, but a nice play by the defenseman to move it up. Yanni Gord, again, delay, drops the defenseman, tries to go saucer, and that's why you got to be careful. And then another quick play. This is what I'm talking about. The speed through the neutral zone created because of some strong passing by the Stars. That trust that I talked about in the first period, another example of it right there.
Offensive zone faceoff for the Stars. They've got their fourth line out there. Caro, after Gardner gets kicked out of the circle, Caro wins it in relief. Klingberg in front, Kiviranta with a shot, and he just put it off the glass. Joel Kiviranta, he's also looking for his first of the season, a couple of helpers in 25 games this year. Grubauer, put a Shea in, and up the wall. McCormick is tied up. McCormick was just summoned from the taxi squad before the start of the game. Puck bounces off of Gardner. Donskoy couldn't initially clear. Second effort he does. Sheahan to McCormick. Had a dozen games last year with Carolina. The Stars saw him a couple times. He actually had a storyline-filled season against Dallas. He was injured by Blake Como on a check. Missed about 3 months. Here's a shot by Yarncroke. Knocked away. And taken by the Stars. They'll look to counterpunch. Ben tosses in. Grubauer. Three starts. Here's Yarncroke. He's got the Kraken goal that came on the power play. As their only tally back in the first. Stars got two even strength. One on a 5-on-3 man advantage. Arrow Haskinen glides up. Right past the check attempt from Blackwell. Turned over, however, and Blackwell, he could have had numbers. Pass banked away from him at center.
The Stars got to be careful here in the second period. The change is now twice. Could have ended up in some very dangerous 2-on-1 outman opportunities. Careful on those changes.
Top line out there for Dallas. They basically had a scoring chance every single time they've been out there in the game. They've accounted for all three goals. Pavelski put it off the skates of Giordano. And just did. Play it from one blue line to another. Ryan Suter collects. Stretched out for Robertson. Couldn't drag the puck with him into Seattle territory. It's Wenberg back the other way. They bank it off the boards. Donato got it to Wenberg. Tied up at the edge of the trapezoid. Out in front. It's kicked off to the far side. Forgan will keep it wide. Donato for Wenberg. Wenberg had a breakout year, 17 goals last year with the Panthers. Here's a shot, hit traffic on its way in and cleared by the Stars. This will be icing against Dallas.
We're gonna go back to the Kiviranta chance off the faceoff. Get a quick little exchange. That's where you could get this Kraken team mixed up a little bit. And then it's the counter here. Yarncroke again. I want you to watch the bodies in front here. Klingberg takes his guy. Everybody's coming back to help. One, two, three bodies in front. And they thwart an effort by this Kraken team.
Shot up high from Larson. Rattles around to the point. Dunn keeps it in. Dunn was a goal-scoring weapon from the blue line in his St. Louis time. Here's a pass from McCann who scores. A saucer pass right on the tape of the Kraken's leading scorer. Jared McCann knows what to do with it. 15th of the year, it's a new career high for him and has Seattle within a goal.
Yeah, highlighted in our little pre-game look. He's the guy that you have to watch for. He's so good at releasing that puck. Eberle collects the puck, throws it across. Oh, what a dish by Eberle to go across. He's got a nifty, nasty little shot. McCann does look at him waiting for it. That puck was bouncing as well, so it's a real nice read. Stars get lost in coverage a little bit, looking towards the puck for guys. They forget Jared McCann out there again. Career high for him in goals.
McCann spent last year with Pittsburgh. He was traded to Toronto just before the expansion draft. That's where the Kraken selected him from. It was one of those moves that was made with the intention that McCann would likely get selected. Toronto and Pittsburgh both had other players that they wanted to protect. As it rides up off the netting out of play. They felt it could be a breakout year for McCann in Seattle. It has been. He's got the latest in a 3-2 Stars lead.
Texas Rangers Knights.
Over on along with Brent Severin. Sevi, you've had the unique experience of being part of an expansion team, 93 in Florida. What Seattle's done has been very impressive from an organizational standpoint.
Yeah, the way they've rolled it out. And of course, you start with a coach like Hextall, who's, you know, communicator, good teacher. Because you've got a group of individuals that have different systems and play different ways, and you got to bring them all together. And that's where our team in Florida had Roger Nielsen, who loved video every day. If you want to know anything about the trap, I'll tell you about the trap. When I see it, I recognize it. It was a difference of a foot, 2 feet one way, making sure that everybody was in unison and working together. And the defense, like Jamie Oleksiak there, have to work together. If they want to work, you got to start with defensive posture, good goaltending. As an expansion team to excel, Seattle struggled a little bit in those two areas.
Systems notwithstanding, what's it like individually when you get guys who have never shared a locker room who all of a sudden come together for something brand new as a chance by Peterson deflects away? This calms down. We'll get back to that. And taken by Wenberg. And tied up. And eventually the crack did come away. Here's Wenberg trying to race three across the line for the Kraken. Giving away to Wenberg. Appleton had snuck out away from the pack. Puck could never get there. Racing down the left wing side. And Dunn, heavy collision right into the netminder Ottinger. He stood his ground. The net stayed on the frame, and we go on.
Yeah, Seattle getting a little bit more up ice pressure now, skating. They're stretching. They're really sending one of their guys like we saw it in that last play. And that's why they're creating some more opportunities up ice.
Icing there on the stretch by Seattle.
Josh, you were asking about what it's like as a group of individuals. Yeah, as an expansion team, you got a common denominator. You've been cast off by other teams and you feel a little bit unwanted. So we in Florida that year, we really banded together, and our job, we thought, was to beat teams 2-1. That's what we did. We slowed it down. We mucked it up. We didn't have any good top scorers, but we did have a great goaltender in John Van Beesbrouck.
That was the refrain that everybody heard for that improbable Vegas run several years ago, the 17-18 season that resulted in a trip to the Cup Final. All the guys that teams didn't want them, and boy, was that ever a rallying cry.
It's like you casting me off to the pregame show. Got rid of me.
Left wing side now, it's played out for Roberts. I think it was the other way around. I came to join you and you gave me the boot. Here's Borgen, lays it up ahead. And behind the net, Grubauer puts it on a bladder. Carson Soucy, turning back behind the Stars net, Ottinger, Michael Raffel. Rink wide, Miro Haskinen. From the red line, he'll toss it in.
A bit of a test match going here. Long stretch passes from Seattle, and then the Stars, nice controlled breakouts to get it down the zone, but back and forth right now for both teams.
Oleksiak able to get it out to neutral ice, and it is touched, whistled down offside. Fans prorated Victory Club membership presented by Lexus are on sale now. Receive access to the remaining Stars home games on the schedule and other amazing benefits that come with being a Victory Club member. You can visit DallasStars.com/victory for more information.
The Stars are just going to have to be careful right on their changes when this is happening. They call it flying guys out of the zone. You want to stretch pass, You're sending your wingers out, and that's kind of creating some space in the neutral zone. And it's really helping the Kraken get out of the defensive zone, but still not much offensively on the other side.
Rockford just outside the Kraken line, and then it's lifted back in. Larson will keep it moving. Fox up, sends it back around. Klingberg, nice rink-wide feed, a shot saved by Grubauer. Rebound is loose. Boxer with that bid, and Grubauer was ready. Work down low, it's Raffle in front! And the puck was swallowed up by the Kraken and just played out. Grubauer was scrambling on his side. Now turned over, two on one, McCann with Eberle. McCann drags, backhand, and he sent it through the crease and wide. McCann has a goal and an assist in the game, and that close to an equalizer for the Kraken. McCormick drops it off for Shane. Dropped by Kiviranta. Behind the net, McCormick. No one home at the far point. Alexiak chases it back.
Yeah, and as a defenseman for the Dallas Stars, when you see this type of play, you got to keep bodies in front of you. You're counting them to make sure you and your defense partner are picking up men. It's just kind of like receivers. You're watching receivers in football. You know what a big fan of the NFL I am there, Josh. But yeah, you got to really be careful and watch where those receivers or those wingers are stepping up through the neutral zone.
It was an evolving road with you in football. We tried our best, and finally we had a breakthrough several years back. It's McCormick back in the defensive half wall. Kiviranta in there for Dallas. It's bumped out to Gardner. He'll swing it across. Sekera winds, fires, and hit his own man. It dropped. Tanner Caro got him right in the back of the legs. And Caro will hobble his way back to the Dallas bench. Whistled down, offside. Caro still feeling the sting of that shot from Sekera. We are midway through. Stars have a one goal lead.
It's John Klingberg. What a heads up play to put that puck across to Radek Faksa. From this angle, look, he's got that corner to go up to, and he just puts it toward the shoulder, and now the other way, two on one opportunity here. And McCann, he's doing his best Denny Savard impersonation with the spinorama. It's fun to watch.
Yeah, he's a fun player to watch. Having a terrific season with Seattle. Here's Wennberg. Left wing side, he gets ridden off by Sagan. Jammed up along the boards. Ben there with Appleton as well. Wennberg dragging him with the speed. Comes free, and Haskin in first on the scene. He'll use the glass, get it out to center. Winds up in the Seattle bench, out of play as we take a look at tonight's Taco Bell take, Sammy.
So we're going to look at what the Stars have done against the new kids on the block right there. Real good job they've done, especially at home. 9-1-2, the first games versus expansion teams. The only loss, as you can imagine, Josh, was against the Las Vegas Knights.
Remember that was a season opener, 17-18. Stars had the 1-0 lead late. Marc-Andre Fleury was incredible, and then James Neal, those two goals to lead them to victory, and that was a train that never slowed down after that.
You got a memory like a steel trap, don't you?
They're feeding it to me down in the truck most of the time.
That's not true.
It's collected, skated out by Dunn, off the chest of Klingberg. Now Blackwell, knocked off, and Dunn will have to delay while the Kraken touch up. Lifted, up by Blackwell, over to Johansson, comes free, high slot, and a shot, a good save. Off the right arm, getting the blocker hand out there, Jake Ottinger.
The Stars continue to give up opportunities here in this second period. Oh, real nice job. Well, Johansson again with traffic. Ottinger, as he's done all year at home, he's definitely got a beat on every puck that's been towards him, with or without traffic.
Faceoff win, Kraken. Giordano with a shot goes wide. There was a lot of traffic taking the eyes of Ottinger away. Stars don't initially clear. Now they will with the pressure applied by Roth.
I think I spoke too soon. You didn't see that one at all.
Here's Suter behind the net. Stars really dominated the opening period of play. They only surrendered the five shots, the one goal. Alexiak throwing a big check on Foxa, the two former teammates. Kraken have tilted the tide here in the middle frame. Getting some better looks, icing here on a stretch pass. They've got the only goal of this second period.
Just the Seattle team's really garnering not only offensive zone plays, but they're in the faceoff. 9 wins, 2 losses for Seattle, so they've upped their presence in the faceoff dot, creating a little bit more. They've definitely made some adjustments to getting out of their own zone, and we talked about the compete. Right here is the first battle of every series in the National Hockey League, and again, Stars come away with it with an opportunity.
Now control up at the left point. Sekera funnels it low for Ben. He gets shoved, just trying to fight his way through the sandpaper from Borgen. Out into the slot. Hopped on Sagan and turning back, Sekera. Andre Sekera, third straight game for him. He was scratched 4 in a row prior to that. Now Ben in front. Peterson, a backhand, and it's turned aside by Grubauer. The same play Roope Hintz tried early in the second period, just a move to the backhand to open him up. Those are two key saves for Grubauer. Behind the net, Peterson, he gets bumped off. Borgen came over from Buffalo in the expansion draft. Now Donato. Appleton knocked down before he could feed it to Donato. Hockenbaum will race the other way. Peterson looked like his stick came up high on Dunn, who was unhappy. Nothing went called. Play goes on. Collision in the corner. Orange arms stay down. Dunn first on the scene. They'll rim it around. Wennberg awaiting. He gets pressured by Sekera. It is offside against the Stars.
Let's go back and have a look at that opportunity by the Stars. Quick up ice pressure. Nice pass here. Watch Jamie Benn. Heads up. Sees Peterson going towards the net. It's the same thing, you're right, Josh. As he garners that puck, he's trying to go between the wickets. Grubauer, but strong in this second period here, closes him up, keeps the stick in the area, and the Stars have another good opportunity. We saw Klingberg make that strong pass across the ice, and a nice play by Jamie Benn with the heads up. Sergei Zubov would be proud.
Dennis Gurianov, one of 3 Stars landing in COVID protocol. He had been really a fixture these last few games on that line with Ben and Sagan. So with his absence, a little bit of a discussion as to who would go up is Jacob Peterson. When he was a surprise out of training camp and made the team back in October, he started the season in a top 6 role. Remember, Jason Robertson was out injured to start the year. So it was Peterson who was playing up in that vaulted spot with Hintz and Pavelski. Don Skoy, stepped in front of by Klingberg. Now up at the line, it's McCormick over to Sheahan. Don Skoy feeds it for Larson. Across, one-timer, Gord. Now Don Skoy with a shot and a glove save by Ottinger. He hangs on to it, we step aside. Just under 6 to play in the second period. All the offense from the Stars provided by the top line, all 3 of them on the board. It's 3-2 Dallas. Continuing a rich hockey tradition in Seattle, and subject of our Chevy under the hood is a man who knows all about it. Look at that, a young Brent Severin played his junior hockey in Seattle. Take you back, buddy?
Yeah, look at the Cooper holes, man. You guys even, kids don't even know what those are these days. Yeah, it was an awesome time there to start as a young kid coming from a small town in Canada, going to Seattle and playing in still one of the loudest arenas I've ever been involved in. And we used to ragdoll Daryl Ray and his Kamloops teams all the time. He's probably watching right now, just rolling his eyes. Sorry, Razor.
He's definitely throwing something at the TV. He's going to get a chance for a retort on that. Loved by Ottinger. It really is such a great sports town, and you don't necessarily think of hockey when you think of Seattle if you don't follow below the professional ranks, but it is a tremendous hockey town when you look at the WHL.
Yeah, absolutely, and the teams there, they got a couple in Everett, one in Everett, one in Kent now, so fairly close to that area. And hey, I still talk to the Billets. Billets are people that I lived with when I was 17 years old. I was 3 years in Seattle. And man, they are still my second family. So it's amazing the bonds you can get, and they are huge, and I mean huge Kraken fans right now.
Looking forward to the trip to Climate Pledge Arena. Stars make only one visit to Seattle this season. It comes late in April. Kraken will be back here a week before the regular season ends, the tail end of April as well. Three meetings in this first go-round between the Stars and Kraken. Offside here, unable to hold it in.
If you could fit me in your suitcase on that trip, I'd love to come see it.
I don't think I can, but I will try if you like. You've seen the arena. It looks like an outstanding atmosphere. They've had a lot of fun there. They're not getting the results they would want. The record hasn't been what they would want, 10, 20, and 4. And yet, in spite of that, when you're going through that first go-round, and you talked a little bit about this with your Florida days, a community that's getting it, you still celebrate every single game, every single milestone.
Yeah, they've done a great job, haven't they, rolling out this franchise. Excellent job in a lot of areas, and that's why I'm jealous that you're going to be able to go see that arena.
You convinced me. I'll take two suitcases. I'll pack you in one. Here's Oleksiak out for Wenberg. Darting down the right side. Sharp angle. Save made Ottinger. And then Donato will move it over to Appleton. Up by Giordano. Kraken on the attack. With zone time. Final 5 minutes of the second period. Stars with a 3-2 lead. They got all three goals back in the first. Kraken have spread it out evenly. First and second, one goal apiece. Giordano, right wing, one-timer. Save made by Ottinger. Familiar face in Jamie Oleksiak, who leaned into that one. Oleksiak has had good numbers against the Stars in his short career against them. Here's Glendening getting a shot away. He goes awkwardly into the boards, tangled up with Giordano. Nothing called. Play goes on. Been three power plays in the game, two for the Stars, one for the Kraken. Both teams have a power play goal. Officials have let them play in this one.
Yeah, Stars starting to skate a little bit more here. About 3.5 remaining here in this period. Got to get something going.
Suter kept it momentarily at the line, then taken away Johansson. He'll race in, has help in trailers, fed to McCann. He overskated briefly, and then he gets knocked down, and that one is going to get called. Holding is the call. Ben Rice smile as he heads off.
It's puck movement in, and then we're going to look at Ottinger, the save that he had, and then Glendening, an opportunity.
That was 14 right off the hook.
Drives the net. No call on that one, but then Jamie Benn gets in the old-fashioned can opener right there. High-scoring McCann goes down. Jamie looks to the sky. Reaches in with those stick. Don't get your feet moving sometimes in transition like that. You're really trying to reach as a player, and that can get you in a lot of trouble.
Ben's expression in the penalty box tells you everything that the captain thought about the call. Second power play for the Kraken. They scored on their first one. It was a beauty of a setup and finish. Callie Yarncroke got it.
That was 14.
Here's Eberle, up high, Giordano to the right wing side, McCann, pass, couldn't get through, sniffed out by Hockenpah and cleared.
Hockenpah's done such an outstanding job on the back end. You've seen his improvement from the beginning of the year, feels more comfortable, especially on the penalty kill with he and Esa Lindell.
Hooking was the call against Ben. Handoff not clean at center, Kraken still get it in. Eberle. Knocked away, Glendening, and eaten up by the skates of Lindell. It is clogged there. Six players, three from either side, digging for the puck on the far wall.
What's that called? It's a stow. It's our second stow of the night. God, Josh.
Now it's a whistle. I forget. I'm rusty on my German. I'll get it by the third period, I promise.
Yeah, I hope that's right. But yeah, that's where this Kraken team, they want to battle. They want to work along the boards as much as possible. They've had some nice movement and some opportunities on their power play. They don't take a lot of penalties, this Seattle team. They just wait for their opportunity to pounce on the power play.
That Stau was blown dead. So the faceoff stays in the Star zone. They win the draw and they clear.
You're getting it.
Got it in. Met my quota. Grubauer, the handoff. Giordano up ahead for Yarncroke. Slow moving pass back for Johansson. Yarncroke will wrist one in and horseshoes to the far side. Stopped by the skates of McCann, over to Johansson. McCann up for Giordano. Eberle back for McCann. 40 seconds left on the power play for Seattle. Stars have a 3-2 lead, just over 2 minutes to play in the second period. Rolling puck, not cleared initially. Now Haskinen will just reach with one hand, poke it across the line. Quickly back in, Jared McCann. Cut off by Ottinger. Haskinen clears it around and pass done at the point.
A little small detail there, Ottinger gets the puck behind the net, and the left-handed shooting Miro Haskinen is coming to get it. He's got to place the puck appropriately, like right in the right lane for to get it out. And I know that's something that goes, you don't really hear too much about, but as a defenseman, you have to do that as a goaltender, and that's why that puck was so easily sent down the ice.
Ben comes free from the penalty box. Stars are through it. Here's Lindell in front. Pavelski scores!
Positioning. You're watching this. Nice forecheck up ice by Glenn Denning. The steal, heads up play, and look at, again, it is Pavelski. Oh, heads up play by Lindell. Plenty of time. I don't know where the breakdown was, but again, Lindell has plenty of opportunity, and look at that. He slices one right between the legs of the defender. Pavelski for another tap in this game.
Lindell picking up his sixth assist. That was picture perfect. All Pavelski had to do was just get the stick down, tap off the blade and in. What a huge goal that is. Kraken turn it over in a sharp angle chance. Ben, Dallas going for more here in the late stages of the frame. Peterson,
one slot
following up Ben. Bumped out on the backhand, Shane. Peterson, right in front of the Kraken bench. Tangled up with his teammate, Ben. Morgan drives it in from center while the Kraken change. It was a delayed offside. The Kraken didn't realize it. Yanni Gord pursued, and that brings the whistle. 43.9 seconds remaining in the frame.
Yeah, you're right, Josh. That's such an important time. The kill, first of all, the Stars do a real good job of getting the puck down the ice, making sure Ben's penalty doesn't allow a power play goal by this Kraken team. And then coming out, and again, it's the puck movement, right? You see so many holes within this Seattle defense, and the Stars are just really finding those little areas, those lanes. And really got a good job, done a good job of scoring goals because of that.
The Kraken this season, it's just plagued them from the start. They've allowed the third most goals per game in the NHL, 3.68 coming into play. The Stars are already at four and only two periods through. Dunn pursued by Hintz. Chipped around off Donskoy, rolls to center. Haskinen took it away from Donato. Retreat for Pavelski. Another two-goal game for him. Off the stick of Hintz. The teams wind up trading goals in that second period. Each number 16 is on the board. McCann and then Pavelski.
Much better push, though, by Seattle early in this game. And Stars were back on their heels a little bit. Seattle created some opportunities, but the Stars, again, as you mentioned, a good kill, come back, get the goal. That's the reason that it's 4-2 stepping into that third period.
Has potential to be a game-defining sequence as the Stars hold at one end and then counter at the other. It's a 4-2 Dallas lead, 40 minutes in the books. Stick around, they'll break it down in the second intermission report. Comes your way next.
To the second intermission report, the Dallas Stars hosting the Seattle Kraken. Seattle would score early in the middle frame, but after Joe Pavelski's second goal of the night late into the period, the Stars double their score, and it's 4-3 Dallas at American Airlines Center. Eagleman. I'm Lauren Callender alongside Brian Ray and Brent Severin. Guys, these two teams traded goals in that frame, but what was really important in this one was coming off of that PK and scoring right away. Ben, that's really encouraging to see heading into the final frame.
Absolutely. And I think, you know, you look at the end of that period, if Seattle scores, it's 3-3 going into third. We kill the penalty. We score the goal. Now it's 4-2. You got a little bit more breathing room. You know, in the intermission, everybody's a little bit happier. So hopefully we can build off that and, you know, keep taking it to them.
I think the breathing room is important. How many chances did we see off the rush for the Dallas Stars when they were close, they were getting close, but they weren't getting that finishing touch? If it's 3-2, Seattle's feeling pretty good, but the Stars get that late goal.
Seattle's Jared McCann gets the Kraken within one. Joe Pavelski, of course, would respond. Brian, let's take a look at the full game highlights first, however.
It's been a big night for the top line, especially Joe Pavelski, but Roope Hintz gets it started. You know, the old shot deflecting off two players in front, Fish. They don't ask how, they ask how many.
Exactly. And again, they do it in the first minute of a game. I don't know how many times they've been doing that this year.
50 seconds into the contest as Roope Hintz gets his 14th of the season. You see the bounce off his skate and Mark Giordano's. And then it was Seattle that would get the power play opportunity for the equalizer. Touch passing in front, and Carly Yarncro finishes it off.
And quick passing at that. You know, all three passes, boom, boom, boom. It's hard for the goalie to keep up to that. Obviously, it's a good shot as well, going far side.
Yarncro on a four-game point streak now. The Stars would get it back fairly quickly. Joe Pavelski, Johnny on the spot on the shot off the end wall, Fish.
Exactly, and there he is finding the, you know, the good ice, the open ice, and it's an empty net.
So Joe Pavelski, that was his 14th. The Stars weren't done. A 5-on-3 power play, cross ice passing. Jason Robertson, what a play.
Exactly. The patience, I can't tell you how patient this is. He gets it, takes his time, goes around the goalie, and he makes it look easy, but that's not easy.
So Jason Robertson with his 13th. Now we go to the second, and the Kraken getting things back to within one, as you will see a feather pass by Jordan Everly from behind the net. Fish, I don't even know what a goalie does on a pass like that.
Yeah, and if you look at it, I think he's even choked up on a stick. Gets it off the glass here. He doesn't even change his top hand. And, you know, all the guys are in the right position. He just makes a good pass. And obviously McCann gets it upstairs quick. And, you know, sometimes you got to tip your hat.
Jared McCann with his 15th. The Stars looking for another goal. They get it late. Esa Lindell picks it off. Joel Podolsky on the doorstep again. There's that fourth one.
And look, an empty net again. It doesn't get too much easier than that. But that's a great pass from Esa Lindell between the D-man's leg here, right through him. That's great vision, great pass, and good finish.
Two goals tonight for Joe Pavelski, 15 on the year as you get one last look at it. That top line, Lauren, has 8 points combined tonight. That is tied for the most they have registered in a game in two seasons of playing together.
They continue to get it done. It'll be a fun third period to watch and see what those guys can do. It's 4-2 Stars in Dallas. When we return, we look at numbers from the first two periods and get you set for the final frame in Dallas. Dallas debut tonight, and after the second period, it's 4-2 Stars at American Airlines Center. And looking at the game stats here tonight, Dallas, look at that, guys, heavily outshooting Seattle, 18-11. Things evening out in the circle here tonight, but obviously a number that stands out to me is Seattle's physicality, 21 hits to Dallas's 11. But another thing that really stands out to me tonight is Jake Ottinger. And Ben, you and I talked earlier today about the way he's able to play the puck. How would you assess the way he's been able to do so in that regard here tonight?
Yeah, he's done great. Obviously, you see there, he gets out, he stops the rim there. He even falls a little bit, but doesn't panic. And here he is, you know, ripping the puck up on the power play. And especially a game like today where he only has 11 shots in the first two periods, sometimes getting out and being able to play the puck like this right there, you know, it helps him stay in the game because it's hard, you know. Sometimes you like to have 30 shots, you know, through two periods, but sometimes it's only 11. You see there, that's a great save. He's big. Even there, it's a great read. He, like I said, he makes it look easy. And then here, obviously, good slide by Klinger, but he stays with it, get knocked over, and kind of keep him in the game. But sometimes when you're not getting as many shots, it's nice to be able to get out and stop the puck, play the puck, kind of stay in the game.
You mentioned the 11 shots and not a lot of activity, you know. For you, you know, for Jake Ottinger, it does feel like it's a position that you need to be in a rhythm. You don't want to have 30 shots up against you through two periods, but how important is that rhythm of seeing the puck and touching the puck?
Exactly, even if it's not making stops, if it's just playing the puck, getting out there, touching it, just staying in the game, because obviously the longer it goes by without anything, you get a little cold, you start thinking, and that's why it's nice to just kind of stay in it, whether it's making a save or just playing the puck.
Okay, guys, we've got the final period coming up next in Dallas. The Stars lead the Kraken 4-2 after two periods of play. We'll see you right after the game for Stars Live postgame.
Welcome back. Josh Bogaard alongside Brent Severin. Stars lead it by two. And through two periods, Sevy, it's been a terrific game for Esa Lindell.
Yeah, you guys always want to talk goaltending and specialty teams. I wonder why. I'm going to talk defensemen for you, all right? So watch Esa Lindell. Yeah, obviously he gets these kinds of opportunities. He does have a sneaky little wrist shot, but watch what he does here along the boards. I love watching him because every time he gets in there, he's going to do this. He's going to out-paddle, out-muscle, nifty little play, and that allows it to go and be chipped out. And then look at this here, lays down, and because he's laying down on a two-on-one, he has to force the opponent to throw it over. And look at this beautiful play. Yep, Joe Pavelski is on the receiving end of a beauty pass.
Lindell with 15 minutes and 18 seconds so far through two periods. It's enough to be second on the Stars for time on ice at this point in the game. Third period underway. It is sent around where, right on cue, Lindell reverses it for Klingberg. 5-on-5, even strength to begin this third period. Stars with a 4-2 advantage. There's Yanni Gord. Gord, one of the many, as you'd expect in an expansion team, to see their role increase from their former team. He was that third liner, a very valuable one in Tampa Bay, and now finds himself firmly in a top six role in Seattle.
You ever get a stone in your shoe, Josh?
Have once or twice.
Yeah, it's annoying, isn't it?
A little bit.
Just doesn't want to go away. This is what we're talking about. This is the type of player that he is. He's going to get in there. He's going to battle. And with Brandon Tanev out of the lineup, he's becoming a fan favorite with his nastiness and hard-working personality out there.
Here's McCann, man of the match so far for Seattle. He has a goal and a helper. He's factored into both. Feeds Eberle with a shot and a save made by Ottinger. One and expect a push from Seattle. Icing again here against Dallas.
Jake Ottinger, not the most busy guy tonight. 12 total shots that we're seeing up on the board here, but watch how he comes out. He's talking to Ben Bishop a little bit about him, and he wants to come out. He's side to side. He's a goaltender that's working on that, but really good at coming out. I think that's why during the break, Jake Ottinger wanted to work on his stance, getting it a little more narrow in the crease area.
Larson moving it near side. The crowd sings along here at American Airlines Center. It's the terrific tradition that has grown here these last couple seasons. Turnaround bid by Donato. That one blocked right back to him. Wenberg behind the net. Cuts to the forehand, looking for Donato, who was a tight angle and off his stick. Went into the slot and then out.
Yeah, the Seattle team struggles a little bit third periods, giving up 46 goals. That's more than any other two periods. This is where they've lost some games, is even though they've played teams strong, little meltdowns in the third period have cost them.
You'd imagine that that's kind of the mantra for both of these clubs. That is a 60-minute game. The Stars have been on both ends of that in their last two games. Seattle coming off of one as well on Monday in Colorado that got away late. Here's Borgen with his shot. Save made by Ottinger.
Nice job in front by Suter to clear it. Nero Haskin and Suter on the ice for that one. I'm sure these days it's kind of hard. You got to be very careful. No more cross-checking. How you protect your goaltender and move bodies in front of the net. Something that, you know, I talked to Suter about it a little bit, of cross-checks and how difficult it is not to do it, having done it so long in his career. There's nothing better than sitting in front of the house and just absolutely laying lumber on that forward in front of you.
Quick shot by Eberle is blocked, and then Ralph runs into traffic. It's funneled low and hops off. Attempting to stop it was Ottinger. He'll settle for the save as it came back in. That puck was loose. Referee lost sight of it, blows it down. And to your point, Sevy, I think whenever you get rule changes like that, it has to always be more difficult on the guys who have been there the longest.
Not saying I was a dirty player, Josh, but I used to do that every now and then.
Another look at Ottinger getting the club down.
Why are you laughing at me?
Oh, no, I remember you from your playing days very well. Not that old. Not from rivaling you on the ice. I meant more from tuning in and catching you from a distance. Comes all the way back out to neutral ice. Soucy. Now it's Glendening. Caught from Johansson. He will turn back for safety behind his net. And Denning never fully let him loose. Morgan rink wide. Bounces off the boards in front of the Kraken bench. Now Johansson offers it out for Morgan, who settles with the reach. Skates into Dallas territory. Sent it around. In the corner, there's McCormick. Plucked loose by the Stars, off the skates of Kiviranta. Oleksiak holds in. His shot goes wide. Everly moves it up high. Giordano deflects to the corner. Kiviranta can turn, lift, and clear. Got a little too much on it, however. Icing against the Stars, and they have some guys who have been out there a while who won't be able to change.
Yeah, Radek Foxa was over by the bench. Kind of buckled over, and you can see that position right there, Josh. What we're seeing right there, that tells you the guys are tired.
Fox has been out there 46 seconds. Lindell and Hockenpah close to a minute. Makes this faceoff key. And it's won by Seattle. Oleksiak leans into one, catches glass on 50-foot slap shot. Now Lindell can clear. Giordano restarts. Appleton was offside. Hockenpah weaves to center. Gets it in deep, and now Dallas can get their change. Giordano for Appleton. Peterson kicked it to Ben, who touched back up cleanly. Low shot attempt was blocked by Oleksiak. Two former teammates go into the corner. And the Stars steal Sagan! And there's a penalty coming for hooking. Sagan stole it away behind the net. Then Ben and Oleksiak exchange a few punches and have to be separated. Sagan's going to go for hooking.
Oh, you're right. Dallas,
31. Running for hook.
Tyler Sagan reaching in here. You'll see Donato, the forward, coming back to help out. And there's the tug right on the left elbow. And that allows the opportunity for Sagan in tight. Both referees had that one and were making the call.
Referees are Justin St. Pierre, Dan O'Rourke, linesman Vaughn Rohde, Tyson Baker. Third power play of the game for Seattle. They're 1-for-2, scored on their first one, didn't convert late in the second period, and seconds later is the most recent goal. Now a neutral ice. Kraken will work it back slowly into their own end. Johansson for McCann. Banked back for Johansson. He gets met, pinned up along the boards. Everly comes away with it. Tried to flip a pass for Yarncroke. It's moved up high. Giordano, now McCann, a one-timer. No problem for Ottinger. Watched it the entire way into his left hand.
Yeah, Ottinger was saying that in the break, you know, watches a lot of video, and one of the tendencies that he watches a lot is power plays and the ability to see where guys are going to place the puck right there. Absolutely reads it. Puck was pretty slow as well, but McCann's got that bomb from distance. Loves that shot from the top of the circle, but you see from the video there, no problem at all for the young fella Ottinger.
Just under a minute and a half to go on the power play. Stars send it around the far boards, not out. Everly to Yarncroke in the corner. Cut off by Suter. Held in Dunn. McCann off for Dunn. Left circle Everly. Top of the zone, done. One-timer missiled off the glass. Johansson turned over. Haskinen, done. Just able to keep it in. Self-preservation, it looked like, to begin. Now McCann for Johansson. In the trapezoid. Flipping along for Everly. Up high, done. One-time McCann. Save. Ottinger tracked it. Good movement here by the Kraken. Back to McCann. Wrister, and Ottinger got that one, too. Goes to the corner, it stayed in play.
Three for a dollar on that side.
Ottinger tested about as much as he's been in any segment of the game. He's been ready. Here's Everly. His shot gets blocked. And then Haskinen battling, and it's moved with a hand pass. 26 seconds to go in the Sagan hook, and nice sequence there by Jake Ottinger.
You know, this is tough on defenders and goaltenders to be down in your zone and going cross ice like this. No screen in front, so you can see Ottinger comes out, challenges this one here, is shanked wide. I think he went off the stick as well as Ottinger went off the shaft and in. Ottinger's been strong on this penalty kill here. About 26 seconds remaining on this one for Sagan to get out of the box.
After the hand pass, the faceoff came out to neutral ice. So the Kraken have to re-enter the zone. Wenberg. Blackwell will softly play in. Ottinger stops it for Lindell. It's around and out, but it hit the glass first. So no delay. The faceoff will stay in the star zone. 10 seconds remaining on the Sagan penalty.
A lot of times as a defenseman on this, when you're killing the penalty, you're actually counting these seconds in your head. There's 10 seconds remaining, so if you get the puck and you have an opportunity to lay a little bit behind the net, hang out, and then you wait for Sagan to get out and then hopefully try to spring him through that. Again, we're talking about Sergei Zubov today. That's what he would do, right? He had that kind of skill where he could just delay a little bit if you get possession.
Giordano to Gord. Final seconds on this Kraken power play. Vince got a piece. Threw off the timing. Puck stays in the zone. Sagan out of the box. Stars have killed off another. Seattle's 1-for-3 on the power play. And it remains a 4-2 Dallas lead.
Josh, we showed Lindell and what he does along the boards. Right there is a perfect example of him winning the battle and just chipping it out. The puck exits the zone.
Wenberg gets it low for Blackwell. He gets hit, stapled hard into the wall by Hockenbaugh. Larson and rink wide. Look out over the glass and a few rows deep. Just over six gone by in the third period. It's a 4-2 lead. Jake Ottinger, strong performance on that last penalty kill. The offense has helped him out. Dallas doubling up Seattle. Resort Durant, Stars 4, Kraken 2, with just under 14 to play in regulation. Another terrific night for Joe Pavelski.
Yeah, what a great play here to start this. Nice little pass. He's got a hefty little pass there. And on this one, just reading the play, he knows that puck's going to be banked off the boards. And then look at this pass to start it off. Boy, that Robertson line again. All over the place, and then the pass from Lindell through the wickets. Pavelski, yes, he's very happy. Another four-point night for the veteran.
17th of his career, the fifth with the Stars, and his second inside a month. He had two goals, two assists, December 18th against Chicago. That was just 5 games ago.
Wish I could bring kids here that want to play up to this level that I work with and skate with and show them how this guy works on the ice every single day. It's pretty amazing, and I know you guys have documented quite often as well. But he just digs in, right? Simple stuff that he digs in and perfects.
It's that question that's been asked. How do you do it at 37 years old? And that's really the answer. In front, it's tipped. That along with an awful lot of talent that's been on display. Continuing from San Jose here to three seasons in Dallas. Puck up into the benches, out of play.
Here's what I'm talking about, Josh. In the morning and in practice, this is what we're going to see. Look at that. There's nobody around. One guy on the ice, and that's all he's doing is tipping. Then we can go away. I believe this is in Vegas. And he's just going to work on this over and over and over again. And this is what we tell kids. It's the repetition that you have to do. If you want to, whatever it is that you want to be good at, you just got to do that. It's his brains. It's his mind. It's his skill that is out in the forefront, but he does so many other things very well, which makes him a complete player.
It's allowed him to keep up with those youngsters as Ottinger collects here, hangs on to it. With that top line with Roope Hintz and Jason Robertson, who are at the other end of their careers. And Pavelski has helped them, match them. They all feed off of each other so well. You don't just get to throw three talented guys together and it always works out. This three, it does, and boy, does it ever.
Yeah, and when you're a young guy, you enter the league and you're around a guy like Joe Pavelski, it's eyes open, ears open, and you are staring and listening to everything he says and trying to mimic the type of success that he's had over his career.
Kraken will grab it, Johansson. 13 minutes left in the third period. Stars with a 4-2 lead. Here's McCann, good play defensively by Glendening. He'll start it the other direction for Foxa. Tries the dasher in deep, Alexiak. And then Hakanpaa will funnel it low. Glendening canceled by Giordano. Giordano, 38 years old, first captain Kraken history. He was the Flames captain dating all the way back to 2013 before he moved in the expansion draft. He's one of several unrestricted free agents to be, so given the way things are going for the Kraken this year, they'll have some choices at the deadline. Here's Suter, the shot that deflects off the end glass. Blackwell in across the Dallas line, banked it off the corner, hits right place, stolen back by Seattle. High slot, Blackwell with a shot snapped off the glass.
That's grand scoring opportunity right there. A little breakdown by the Stars.
Blackwell scored in their last game. This is just his 13th game of the season. He's off to a tough start. The injury front to his Seattle career. A terrific look right there.
So what's the Stars here? Give up that opening. Blackwell determined to get to that area of the ice. And what a nice save there. And that. This is why goaltenders is as big as they are right now. You know, you got Ben Bishop over to our right, working the booth, and yeah, that's what he did. Keep that body upright. Good strong push side to side and take away the top of the net. Excellent save by Ottinger.
Shot at the other end right off the draw by Klingberg, and that hit Grubauer and bounced high off the netting.
Yeah, they slowed down a little bit here in the third period, which I believe is going to favor the Stars. You don't want to give any life to this Seattle team who's trying to generate as much as they can on every opportunity.
Right back to Klingberg again, another face-off win. Shot stopped, and then Peterson sent it wide of the cage. Riley Sheahan ahead for Donskoy. Not for neutral ice. Ben stepped on a stick, went down. Play goes on, draws a roar from the crowd. Peterson skates away from the pressure, the wide turn, and across for Ben. They'll try and take on Soucy. Yeah, it's canceled out, tied up. Donskoy the other direction. A tough year for Jonas Donskoy. No goals, 34 games in. Been a 14-17 goal scorer the last 4 years, both in San Jose and Colorado. He's got 14 helpers, but hasn't been able to break the seal in the goal-scoring department for Seattle just yet.
And that's the thing about getting with an expansion team. It gives you added opportunity, but you have to make the most of that extra ice time and opportunity, and he hasn't done that for the squad.
Collected on the wall by Rhett Gardner in his Dallas season debut. It's his 37th NHL game. Goes to work on Larson. Plays keep away. Outlet feed Appleton. Reached by Haskinen, and now Raffle holds it in. He gets hit by Dunn. Larson the circle. Been 5.5 years since the one-for-one deal. Sent him to Edmonton for Taylor Hall. Another former Oiler, Jordan Eberle down the left wing side. Shoveled the backhand that goes wide and rides the boards back to the Seattle end.
It's so frustrating for a team when you're coming down, you got a little bit of juice going toward the net, and then you have the forward just ripping around and ends up back in your own zone. You got to go down 200 feet to pull it back.
Hakanpaa is hit by McCann. Robertson got in there. Eberle gets it back for Seattle now. Hakanpaa didn't allow entrance to the slot. Knocked to the circle. Johansson the reach. Bunts it to the corner. Lindell first on the scene, reverses things. Pavelski and Eberle after it. Eberle near side, up to Alexiak. Slides it across Giordano. Shot. Ottinger with the save, and he hangs on. Half a period to go in Dallas. It's the Stars with a 4-2 lead. Plays of the game takes a look at the night for Jake Ottinger.
Yeah, he's had a strong game here. I want you to watch how far he's out on these. It's the big body. It's amazing when you're at ice level. This is kind of what you see. Not much to shoot at, so you got to go upstairs. When you go upstairs, you have that big frame. Great numbers for him.
It's hard to imagine any better start to your home career than that. Points in 20 of 22 decisions. He and the Stars in the driver's seat with a 4-2 lead. Just over 9 to play here as Grubauer sends the long distance shot up and out of play.
I still remember that we had a little press conference with him and he was going to go down and he was so determined. You could just tell, A, he was a little bit miffed that he was going to be sent down. B, he was letting us know that this is not going to be for very long because he came to camp this year to have a spot. He wanted to play. And because he has his patience and his hard work, here he is with Anton Hudobin backing up.
Braden Holtby, one of three who's been placed into COVID protocol, so Hudobin gets recalled. He played four games down with the Texas Stars. Went 1-3. It was his first AHL experience since 16-17 season with the Providence Bruins. He was in the Boston organization. Stars have a back-to-back this weekend, a tough one at that. In Florida Friday, Tampa on Saturday, and see what Rick Bonus elects to do with his netminders. Knocked out of midair by Hintz, but claimed by Seattle. Ford will shoot it in. Yarncroke, hustled off by Heiskanen. Now Gordon Pavelski. Gord stays upright to Morgan. Now across, Soucy, shot redirected. To the near side, a chop by Hintz. Couldn't get it past the body of Morgan. Seattle on the attack. Soucy sends it wide. Karam off the corner. And it's Gord. Heiskanen just stripped it away. Laid it off to the far corner. Good hustle, Suter, and Dallas gets it out. Morgan restarts. Here's Donato. Down the right side, turning the corner on Haskin, and a shot save made by Ottinger. He went to the forehand, and Ottinger didn't give him much to shoot at. Thought he might cut a little bit more inside.
Yeah, he didn't bite on it at all, did he? Just held his ground, and that made it very difficult to get that puck anywhere.
Dunn to Larson. Uses the glass to get it out to center. Secker and Donato were tied up there. No icing as it slowly coasts behind the Stars' end line. Lindbergh on the stick of Foxa, shot in from center ice. Dunn pursued by Glendening. Clock continues to move. It's a friend of the Stars. Here's Sekera. Tried to play it across. Hit Glendening's skates, eventually got to Klingberg, and then won back by Larson. Stretched out Johansson. Slipped to McCann in front. Eberle saved by Ottinger. Point blank, Ottinger. One of his best of the night on Eberle.
Yeah, real nice job here. 3-on-2 opportunity for the Kraken. And nice job by Ottinger again. Solid. That's what it is. 4-2 game, right? These guys, Kraken, have to take some risks. They get a 3-on-2 opportunity, and Ottinger shuts him down.
McCormick for Donskoy. Now Sheahan on the near side. Hockenpah rubs out McCormick. Ben leaves for Hockenpah, turns away from one. And Donskoy is another right there. Jonas Donskoy in the trapezoid. Ben just out-muscles it, takes it away, flips ahead. Peterson with a step, cutting in, delays. Nowhere to shoot as he kept it low, paddled down from Grubauer. Back and forth stretch here. Late in regulation. Stars can't connect on a pass. It's icing against Dallas.
You're looking at Ottinger's little body of work here. That's Donato skating down, goes past Miro Heiskanen. Like you say, he just held his stance up in front and then watch this one across here. Oh, he stretched it out on Eberle, and then Peterson with an opportunity coming in. You know, both goaltenders, because of some strong work by their defenders on that last play especially, Grubauer just has to lay down the paddle. Nowhere to go if your D-man is coming back to help.
Kiviranta clears to center. Larson over to Dunn, and then Gord let it go through his skates but couldn't take the angle as he was played off by Kiviranta. The wall in Kraken territory. Dunn for Larson. Delays and then puts it ahead for Gord. Yanni Gord leaves for Blackwell. Back in front, Gord got a piece, sent it well wide. Gardner nudges it up ahead, out of the reach of Haskinen. Blackwell retreats for Borgen. The Stars center logo dumped in, bounces its way near side, past Johansson. Now Pavelski, 4 points on the game. He's had a hand in every Stars goal. He scored two, assisted on the other two. High in the air, and it bounces on the near wing. Good anticipation, interception, McCann. That's Lindell. Back with it in Dallas territory.
Instrumental, again, Pavelski getting the puck out, first of all, then coming back, tracking back, getting the stick in the lane, and that's why the puck was diverted in the neutral zone, and Seattle was unable to create anything off that little tiny rush.
Kraken controlling, up ahead, Renato, and then it's poked away. Appleton brings it back in, feeds it for Wennberg. Foxy tries to steal and go the other direction. Stayed in the zone. Along the near side, banked up, Oleksiak holds it to Appleton. Swung across, Giordano, winds, doesn't shoot, feeds it top of the zone, Oleksiak. Jamie Oleksiak flipped a pass, it was tough for Giordano, couldn't handle it, Hockenpock and clear. Oleksiak goes back to chase. It's icing against the Stars. They wanted to change. They won't be allowed to with 4:05 left in regulation.
Yeah, Stars just have to continue to do what they're doing here. Be strong with the third man high. Nothing crazy. You get an opportunity, you go. 4 minutes remaining and it's 4-2, right? This is the kind of game you're going to want to play. You're going to feel that Seattle's got to force. This is where they've been a lot, Seattle. Down in a game, have to push, you're going to make mistakes, team's going to capitalize, and that's why when you look at it, they've given up so many goals in that third period. And you're giving up 46 goals in third periods, that's a lot. This is where they struggled as well, 5-on-5. They've given up more than anybody in the NHL in that regard.
Logged up in the corner, taken by Hockenpock. Tried to lift it out, played with a high stick by Gord, then he touches, but they say it was legal and low enough. Stars will take Glendening. He tries to spring Peterson on the bank pass. Dunn to cut off the angle, and then Larson ran into Peterson right as he lost control of the puck. Stretched out and on net, so Andrej used the stick to steer it aside. No icing. More time comes off the clock, though. Under 3.5 to go now in the third period. Score hasn't changed since the intermission. That's no problem for the Stars. You've got the 4-2 lead. Oleksiak behind his net. Headed up the left side. Carson Soucy hit the red line. Ottinger turns to feed it back to the corner. Collision, Wennberg and Klingberg. Now Donato, a wraparound, save made, rebound, fired off the post. Ottinger there, hangs on to it, and then he takes exception to the late poke by Donato. Ben is right there, but Ottinger wanted a word himself. What a sequence. Ottinger with the initial save, the scramble afterwards. And it's still 4-2 Dallas.
Of this game, we're going to go all the way back. Early on, quick little shot here, goes off Roope Hintz in front of the net. That first line gets going, starts to build some confidence, and then this here shot off the boards, and there's Joe Pavelski, perfect position, just taps it home, and Pavelski all over the map in this one tonight, Josh. Quick little pass up, then it goes to Robertson, who makes a nifty little move on Grubauer. And then we showed Essa Lindell this pass through. Nice, strong effort, and Pavelski has again been leading the charge for this club. Outstanding effort. You see it right there. One of the best starts in the National Hockey League for him. Look at those points here, Josh. Pretty amazing.
Better than point per game through the first 33. Now or never time for the crack, and they pull their goaltender coming out of the break. Quickly cleared by the Stars, so Seattle can't take advantage of the offensive zone faceoff. They'll have to re-enter now from their own zone. Here's Yanni Gord, 6-on-5 for Seattle. Eberle to McCann. Gets it low. Hakanpää moves it over to Lindell. He'll take a shot at the empty net from one corner, winds up in the other, and 200 feet later, that's ice.
Well, he's got the apple. You might as well go for the
that's right.
For the net. I still find that strange, Josh, and maybe I'm just an old fart, but I find that strange that they continue to go for this. Yeah, it makes sense, but if you did that in my era, oh, geez. I don't think you'd see the ice again for the next three games. So that means I am an old, you know what.
Face off inside the star zone. And Seattle wins another one. Giordano, shot. The traffic in front. And then the putback effort by Yarncroke goes wide to the corner. Here's Johansson. Still remains a one-man advantage with an empty net for Seattle. Eberle fired off the end glass, and how calm is that? Jake Gottinger just reaches back, handles it, hangs on, 2:09 to go.
Yeah, Seattle's getting some opportunities in front. You see the quick shot from Giordano. That's what he does a lot. And look at the traffic in front of the net. You're trying to sort out. You got three Kraken and a couple Stars, excuse me. Unfortunately, again, Ottinger setting up shot, using that big body, taking out the bottom of the cage and protecting the top with the torso.
Kraken have crawled in front. The shots on goal department. Stars aren't concerned about that. They've got the 4-2 lead, but they're going for the finish. Yarncroke in the corner, taken away. Pavelski had a bid for the hat trick from his own corner. And a stick goes flying of Johansson after he breaks it. Sent all the way down. This will be another icing against Dallas. Stopping the clock with 1:51 to go.
I don't know what happened there, Josh.
It's
a stick'em or something needed on that. Loss of the utensil.
Joe took the shot from the corner. It's easier to do it, you were talking about it, with a two-goal lead. You want to salt it away. The Stars, yes. This is an area where they've had a little bit of difficulty. They've seen some goals. Protecting one-goal leads late. Certainly there was controversy last time out in St. Louis, but they also had the game against Florida. They saw extra attacker. This one will roll towards the cage and in! 200 feet! Yanni Hakanpää! And what a way to get your first in Dallas! The exclamation point on the evening for the Stars.
Yeah, they practice it a lot, Josh. We watch in Frisco. They go through this scenario quite often here where you're going to get the puck and now you got room, and look at this thing trickle home. They don't ask how, they ask how many. Hakanpää filters it out. Again, we talked about how strong he's been on the penalty kill. 5-on-5, and it's nice to see him get that one right there. A little grit too. Love it.
He had 2 goals in 57 games last year. That is his first goal this season in his 32nd game for the Stars. In this much anticipated first ever meeting between Dallas and Seattle. Down to 1.5 minutes to go. Stars with a 5-2 lead, inching their way closer to improving that terrific record against expansion teams in the debut meeting. Centering pass, Donskoy! Looking to break his zero, and Ottinger with his latest.
Hero Haskin got hit with the puck or something and went down and was hobbling a little bit, but he seems to be back up on the wheels.
Ottinger drifts behind the net and keep it moving for Haskin. Pavelski for Carroll out of his reach and then off of Oleksiak. In the final minute. Here's Oleksiak. Up ahead, Chip Donato got past Appleton and Wenberg. Back in the Stars, Klingberg finds Robertson, delays, dropped it off in front, loose puck. Grubauer was scrambling over to Pavelski. Grubauer resets, the Stars still on the attack. Pavelski settles, what a save! Grubauer lunging to his right, robbed the hat trick bid from Pavelski. Pavelski, another tight angle shot, stopped. How about those chances? How in the world did Dallas not get their sixth? Hintz trying to flip it ahead, winds up in the Stars bench, 7.3 to go, and all Joe Pavelski can do is smile and a glove tap for the opposing netminder.
If you've seen the movie Slapshot, this is exactly what they show in the movie. Goaltender under barrage. Boy, what an opportunity here. This could be one of the saves of the year here. Watch as he comes back right there, gets the blocker. Oh my goodness, little bit of a giggle there from Pavelski. Oh my goodness, he had to pull it down. The puck was on end a little bit, and that's why he didn't get all of it. And he's like, ah, nice save, buddy.
He put it where he wanted to on the inside portion of the net. Grubauer was just better. Final seconds will tick off. The night started with the question of how would the Stars respond after that last game on Sunday. A few hours later, you get your answer, led by Joe Pavelski, and a 5-point night. They get their response and a huge victory, another one on home ice.
I like the way the Stars started this one. They knew they had to come out early on in this game in that first period, got the goals, then were able to set up their structure. A little push in the second period, I thought, by the Kraken team, but the Stars, again, love to see this. When you play these type of teams that are under 500, Stars coming up 6-8 against that, so they are going to have to continue to win these types of games.
Great job by you, my friend. This was a blast. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
For Brent Severn, our terrific crew, I'm Josh Bogorod. Wire-to-wire win for Dallas, 13-1 in their last 14 at home. 5-2 the final. Stick around. Post-game show is next.
Of Stars Live presented by Frontier Communications. The Dallas Stars and Seattle Kraken met for the first time tonight, and the Kraken received a warm welcome from the Stars top line, which accounted for four of Dallas's goals tonight. Final score 5-2 Stars at American Airlines Center. Welcome in. I'm Lauren Callender alongside Brian Ray and Ben Bishop, who joined us for the broadcast tonight. Guys, a 5-2 win. Bish, in your first broadcast with us, a pretty good outcome for you, huh?
Good luck, I guess. No, but it was nice to see the way they responded. We talked about that before the show and how we would come out tonight, and I think all three periods we did a great job.
Superstitions in sports is very simple. Sevy's got to stay off the set. You got to stay on until this team loses. It was a good response tonight from the Stars.
Did you have fun?
I had a great time. Okay. Thank you, guys.
All right. We're going to join us now. Joining us now is Brent Severn, who we did miss tonight, but he had a great call. It's tonight's Frontier post-game reaction. Sev, we missed you, but a fun one for you to call here tonight. The Stars pick up 2 points after a tough loss in St. Louis. This one, their frustrations, they brought him here, they got him out, they got the win. What'd you think of tonight's big win?
Well, first of all, I just heard Brian here. You understand, I can hear you.
I know, that's why.
Far away, and you're just giving it to me. Yeah, well, Bish, I think it was because of you, too. I'm sure you're going to be talking all about this goaltending, right? But what an outstanding job by the Stars. Yeah, coming into this one, as you just mentioned, Lauren, what would be the response from the team after what we saw in St. Louis? But there really at no time in this game did I feel that the Dallas Stars were any type of trouble. Going down the road, obviously they got to watch and respond properly, but when you're looking at Pavelski and that top line coming out early in this game, scoring those goals, taking control of the game, they really dominated, because this is what happens to Seattle quite often. They get down in games, they can't come back, they got to take chances, and then they have a team putting a 5 spot on them. So, outstanding game on for everybody across the board. This is a good one. The Stars needed this one. And when you look moving ahead, they're going to play 6 of the next 8 against teams with a below 500 record. You have to win these type of hockey games. It's going to be important moving forward.
Hey, Sevy, obviously, you know, Pavelski, Robertson, and Hintz are always on the score sheet, but how nice is it to see Hakapov get his first goal? One of those guys that does all the little things right, kills penalty. And I know you like to see those guys score goals.
Absolutely. Thank you for bringing them up. I thought you were going straight to the goaltender. But, yeah, you appreciate those type of players so much. They're the guys like Lindell and Hakanpaa. They grind it out for you every night. They're the ones battling in front of the net for you, blocking those shots. And, yeah, when we get the chance to chip in and get a little cheesy one from 200 feet, we're going to take it.
Sevy, we've talked a lot about the Stars' offense. It's great to see them get a 5 spot, but the three of us were talking during that second period, rush chance after rush chance, and they just could not get that goal. And then Pavelski taps in the one late to make it 4-2, a little bit of breathing room. You, as a defenseman, entering an intermission, a third period, how vital was that fourth goal for the Dallas Stars in the grand scheme of things?
Yeah, absolutely. But the start of the game, the Stars were able to really exit the zone with ease, right? They supported well. They moved the pucks out. Great job by the defenseman to find the forward coming through, and that's the reason they were able to get something going in that first period. Second period, you saw that Seattle was stretching a little bit more, creating a little bit more pressure, and turned it a little bit on the Stars. But yeah, the minute they get that last goal there, now they can relax, play the way they have to, and come away with the win.
All right, thank you, Sebi. Great call here tonight. We missed you, though.
Oh, sure you did.
I did.
Thanks, Lauren. I appreciate that.
Brian, we had a fun one here tonight, a busy first period. Why don't you walk us through tonight's full game highlights?
A lot of highlights, and if they're for the Stars, that usually means for a fun postgame show. Bish, welcome to your first winning edition of Stars Live, the postgame edition. Look, it was the top line 50 seconds in, and the double deflection off the skate of Roope Hintz, and then Mark Giordano to put the Stars up 1-0.
And it's nice to get that bouncer in the game, especially with the bounce that, you know, kind of ended the game in St. Louis. So to have a good bounce in the first minute of the game is great.
14th of the season for Roope Hintz. And for Jason Robertson, who got the assist, that's an 11 home game point streak for him. But Seattle would respond on the power play, touch passing, and Cali Yarncroke in front finishing.
And he's been one of their hottest players, and it's no surprise to see him get on the score sheet early, but just a great passing play by them and a good finish.
You mentioned the heating up Cali Yarncroke, 4-game point streak now for him. But the Stars, their offense was clicking in this first period. Joel Pavelski on the doorstep, big night for him. There's the first one.
Yep, Johnny on the spot. He's been there a couple times tonight and is able to put it in into a, you know, an empty net. And he'll always take those.
Great bounce off the end wall to set up the Pavelski goal. Then the Stars with a 5-on-3 power play. You love this work by Jason Robertson.
Yeah, and even the passing before that. But yeah, just the patience. It's hard to find guys that have that much patience. And not only that, but he makes it look easy at the same time.
Just to cradle the pass and slip it home, his 13th of the year. Stars have the 3-1 lead after one. We go to period two. Seattle hanging around. Jared McCann is going to finish off a nifty little play. The pass from Jordan Eberle behind the net right there sets it up.
That's a great pass, but also a great finish. McCann gets it up top right away. Doesn't waste any time. He gets that puck on and off his stick, and that's what makes it hard for Chief to try to get across.
15th of the season for McCann. That line has been very good for Seattle. The Stars able to contain them a bit, and the Stars would get it back. Here's the late goal, the fourth one. Esa Lindell to Joel Pavelski alone again.
Probably one of the most important, you know, plays of the night going into that third period now with a 4-2 lead and just killing off that penalty and a great pass from Esa, and again, Johnny on the spot.
The Stars had a big penalty kill, as Bish said, right before that goal was scored. So they take the 4-2 advantage into the locker room. An empty netter from Yadi Hakanpaa seals the deal at 5-2. And it's another home win for the Dallas Stars. I believe they're now 13-1. In their last 14 home games. This is not a fun place to play if you do not play for the Dallas Stars.
Well, Joe Pavelski doesn't make it a very fun place to play, right? And he's joining us now. We're going to welcome Joe in to Stars Live down on ice level. Joe, two goals for you tonight, another big night for you on home ice. How do you and your line mates continue to get things done so consistently well here at home?
I think the compete right from the start's been great for us. Our, you know, we come out, we get a few pucks deep, and the forecheck, you know, it's there right from the first shift. And Roope won a few draws early, created some time in the O zone, and you know, we definitely found some space around the net tonight.
Hey, Pav, it's Bish up here in the studio here.
Man, you got a great voice, Bish.
Yeah, I just wanted really to know, are you using that stick that Bones was crushing? You got two goals with that stick tonight?
Yeah, I got to give Bish a little, or Bones a little credit there. He woke the stick up for me, and yeah, it was good to see it going in the net.
No, but obviously it was a great night for you guys, your line, and scoring those, just Johnny on the spot all night, getting those empty net goals. I know the boys were looking for you at the end there, but great save by Grubauer. It was fun to see you kind of go down and give the goalie some credit.
It was. You know, you guys work hard, and, you know, they play. Gruby battled right to the end. I thought I made a good shot, and he came flying across. So it was just a fun night. The game was over, so, you know, guys were a little aggressive there, and they were looking for us. And, yeah, well, just overall, it was good. It was a good game. It was a great rebound. You know, when we've lost games, we haven't come back with a good performance, and that was something we wanted to talk about. We wanted to establish our game again right back, and we're playing good hockey.
Joe, we heard the message from Rick Bowness the last 2 days about moving on from that game in St. Louis and channeling that frustration.
Does that game linger at all over the last 2 days for you guys entering this one, or was it pretty much a closed book and this was solely about this one tonight?
Yeah, it was about moving on in a group and being, you know, kind of mentally tough, and those things happen. You know, we're going to get our fair share of bounces throughout the season, and, you know, that was a tough one the other night. We played a good game. It's how it goes. It's hockey. So it was a good job by the guys rebounding, you know, get a day off, good quick little practice, and guys are ready.
Well, Joe, I just want to say your hair looks great. That's a nice haircut from the other day.
Man.
Looking fresh.
Yeah, it feels good, I got to admit.
All right, Joe, thanks for joining us. Congrats on another great game from you here tonight. And, guys, Joe and his line, again, so incredible. They're consistent. They're fun to watch. But these two right here, Jason Robertson and Joe Pavelski, 6 goals each at home. Look at 11 assists for Robo, 17 points on the season at home. What's there to be said about the way these two have been playing in particular?
Well, I think just the way they look for each other, even there at the end of the game when the game was basically over. I mean, some of those passing plays to get past the puck there at the end of the game, that's some slick passing. So the way that they look for each other, the way they're always trying to find the other guy, they're all unselfish players, you know, they don't want to be the one that scores the goal, and they're always looking for each other, and that's what makes them all successful.
It's always interesting to watch these three play together, and Rope Hintz is going to feel a little left out of that graphic because he was pretty darn good for this line tonight. 10 points combined, but, you know, Bish, I'm curious how you look at this as a goaltender. It's not always tape-to-tape passes with these three players. It's almost just an area pass. They know where to put it to let the other guy go get it. It's not this textbook tape-to-tape pass that's almost like a video game almost that sets things up. You know, an area pass versus that on the tape of the stick pass. Is there a difference? Is there a way to read that as a goaltender? It feels like it's an area pass that they thrive on.
Well, they're just feeling it right now. And I think, you know, they're building that every single game. But I think what makes them great, too, is that they all contribute. You know, they all do the little things right. It's not just one guy, even though they all have their own, you know, special talents. But they all contribute every night. They're always, you know, looking to pick each other up. And I think that's what makes them so great.
Here's a question for our resident goaltender tonight. We've seen a lot of points put up by the top line of Pavelski, Robertson, and Rope Hintz. Who has the most dangerous shot out of those three and why?
Well, they all have different shots.
That's why I'm asking you.
Yeah, no, I mean, Rupe probably has the hardest one. Pav is a smart shooter, the way he pulls and pushes the puck before he shoots the puck. And then Robo's he's kind of sneaky. You know, he likes to go the five hole. He picks his head up and he picks his spot. So they're all very different shooters, but it's interesting to see how they all kind of help each other out. But, yeah, all different shooters. I mean, say Rupe is definitely the hardest shot. And then Pav is one of the sneakier ones. And then, you know, Robo kind of goes everywhere. So he's tough. He's patient, too.